Welcome dear students, today we are going to learn the CHR 230 course, that is section 2, Bio Inorganic Chemistry. Today we are going to learn the kinetic aspects of bio inorganic compounds. We already discussed the inert and labile complexes. Here in inert complexes, how we identify the inerts and labile complexes? Simply, here the electron which is present in T2G level, EG level, that complexes are called as the labile complexes, and the electron of the d orbital present in T2G orbital, that are the mostly inert complexes. We already discussed in detail in earlier lecture. Next, that is the substitution reaction. This is also we learn in detail in the our second course, that is the CHG290 course. We already discussed what is the substitution reaction, their types, in their types, that is interchange reaction, and also the dissociation reaction, association reaction, all we completed in this section in the organometallic chemistry. Okay, today we are going to learn the next topic or next point of the kinetic aspect, is electron transfer reaction. Okay, this is also very much important, because here for the doing the different mechanism in our body, the electron transfer is very important. For example, for the photosynthesis process, here the nitrogen required the electrons, and these electrons which comes from the pyridoxine or rubidoxine, that is FeS cluster. Okay, and here this FeS cluster do this type of reaction, that is what, electron transfer reaction. This FeS is useful for the storage of electron and also the transportation of the electron. But here, how this electron transfer can be takes place, let we learn in this topic. And here this electron transfer is the kinetically stable complex reaction. There are the two major pathway are given for the transfer of the electron. There are two pathway of the transfer of reaction, transfer of electron. In that, the first pathway is known as inner sphere electron transfer. The first pathway, that is what, inner sphere electron transfer. And the second pathway, that is outer sphere, outer sphere electron transfer. These are, both of these are very important in the net set point of view, because on the basis of that always ask the question in net set exams. So let me start first, that is the inner sphere electron transfer. Inner sphere electron transfer, in that what happen, this can be characterized by, here this inner sphere reaction, how we characterize, this can be characterized by presence of one or more bridging ligand. One or more what? The bridging ligand. Bridging ligand, which are directly bounded to the coordinated sphere of the reactant. This can be directly bounded to the coordination sphere of the reactant. Okay, this is the main characterization method for the inner sphere and the outer sphere reaction. In the outer inner sphere reaction, what is the main characterization? It is characterized by its presence of one or more bridging ligand, and this bridging ligand mostly electronegative ligand like chlorine, fluorine, bromine, etc. This have the negative charge. Mostly these electronegative ligands are present as a bridging ligand in the inner sphere electron transfer reaction. Let me see their mechanism, how this happen. Here in this reaction what happen, our reactant is, let me see the reaction of inner sphere. Okay, here this cobalt, which is cobalt NH3 5 Cl complex is there. This complex has +2 oxidation state, is reacted with chromium H2O6 2+ oxidation state. Okay, then this reactant get converted to, by addition of 5H2O molecule, this get converted to cobalt H2O6 complex having 2+ oxidation state and chromium H2O5Cl. Okay, and this having +2 oxygen state. Here you can see this is electronegative atom. In first case, in case of reactant, this is reactant and this is product. In first case, this reactant, this cobalt which having what, +3 oxidation state, and this chromium which having a +2 oxidation state. Here this is the electronegative atom which is present over here, and after the formation of product, this electronegative atom is goes to the next ligand, next metal, that is chromium. Okay, and where the, this is present in the coordination sphere. Okay, here in case of product, what happened, this cobalt which having what, their oxidation state +2, and here this chromium which having oxidation state +3. That means what happened here, this cobalt in reactant which having +3 oxidation state, it get changes to cobalt +2 oxidation state. How this happen? By what, gain of electron. It gain the electron and it get changes to cobalt +2 oxygen. That reaction is called as what, reduction reaction. Okay, and here in this case, next case, what happened, this chromium in reactant, this chromium having +2 oxidation state, it get converted to chromium having +3 oxidation state. How this happen? By the loss of electron. Okay, here this chromium which lost their electron and get converted to the +3 oxidation. That means here the oxidation which can be taxed place. Okay, that means this reaction shows the redox reaction. Okay, and here why this is the inner sphere reaction, because in intermediate state what happened, there is a formation of a bridging ligand. In the intermediate state, this electronegative ligand which will form a bridged. Okay, how it form the bridge, like this manner. Here NH3 5 attached to cobalt, and here this is the chlorine which bridge with the chromium. Okay, which is attached to high moles of water molecule. Okay, and here this complex having charge +4. Okay, here in this reaction, after the formation of this, this ammonia get converted to what? Ammonium ion NH4+. Okay, this is the reaction, and in the intermediate state here there is a formation of the bridging ligand. Formation of what? Bridging ligand. Due to the formation of this type of bridging ligands, we can characterize that this is the inner sphere reaction. This is what? Inner sphere reaction. Understood? Next we are going to learn next point, that is outer sphere electron transfer. What is outer sphere electron transfer? This is the process in which there is a direct transfer of electron without formation of bridging intermediate, without formation of bridging intermediate. This is very much important to characterize inner sphere and outer sphere reaction. In the inner sphere reaction, there is a formation of bridging intermediate, and here in the outer sphere electron transfer reaction, this is the direct transfer of electrons takes place without formation of the bridging intermediate. It takes place, and that's why here there is a minimum energy in metal ligand distance electron transfer process. Okay, there is no bridging takes place, and that's why here it requires very minimum energy. Okay, and that's why this type of electron transfer is very fast. Okay, this is very fast. Let me see the example of this reaction. This is our FeL6 having plus 2 oxygen state, which is reacted with the IRL6 having plus 4 oxygen state. It get converted to FeL6 plus 3 oxygen state plus IRL6 plus 3 oxygen state. That means direct conversion is takes place over here. That is what happened here. This Fe here, in this case, this Fe having what? Plus 2 oxidation state. This is having plus 4 oxidation state. And then here this is get the plus 3 oxidation state. What happened here? That means Fe, which having the electron which is reacted with IR, which having plus 4 oxidation state, then it get converted to Fe3 oxidation state plus IR3 oxidation state. Okay, that means what happened? Fe2, which lost their electron and get converted to Fe3, that is oxidation takes place over here, and here this IR, which having plus 4 oxidation state, which accept the electron from this Fe and get converted to IR3. That means here the reduction is takes place over here. The redox reaction is takes place over here. Okay, this is what? The inner sphere and outer sphere reaction. This is very much important reactions. Electron transfer reaction always asked in net set examination. How to identify in the inner sphere and outer sphere? The inner sphere reaction always form a bridging ligands or bridging intermediate, and in case of outer sphere, this is the direct transfer of reaction is takes place. Okay, and there is no formation of what? The bridging intermediate. Okay, this is about the this kinetic aspect, that is inner electron transfer reaction.